Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I just want to talk about some basics concerning circles, that is some terminology, and also how to find the circumference of a circle. The figure below shows the circle and all the important terms associated. The diameter, which you can see the definitions over here, the diameter is the distance across the circle through the center. But what is the circle in general? It's a set of all points that are equidistant from a point in the center. So if this is your center point, every point on the circle is the same distance from it. The radius is the distance from the center to a point on the edge of the circle, and the circumference is the distance around the circle. When we deal with circles, you know you've heard pi before, because here's the formula for finding the circumference of a circle is diameter times pi, that is this diameter times pi, or 2r pi. And 2r pi and diameter pi are actually the same thing, because the radius is half the length of the diameter. So we could say d over 2 to get the radius. Or if we knew the radius, we could say 2 times the radius to get the diameter. So when I say d, or if I replace that by 2r, do you see how those are the same thing? 2 radii is a diameter. So you could use either formula depending on whether you're given a radius or a diameter. And then we have pi, which is an irrational number, and that means that it never ends or repeats. So whenever we talk about pi, if we want to use it for a calculation, we can't use a number that goes on forever. So we have to shorten it or round it, which is actually an approximation then. So for our purposes for right now, I'm going to say we're going to use pi approximately 3.14. Okay, and then I just want to explain to you where pi came from, because sometimes people just, it's this number that makes absolutely no sense to them. It's just this number that has no meaning, except they know the value of it. Well, I'm going to start. I drew a circle already because I couldn't draw a circle on my own. But what if you live back in the day where there was no circles? Right now, you could grab anything around you right now, and you could find a circle and make a circle, trace it. But back in the day, people didn't have perfect circles. How did they do it? Well, they put a stick in the ground, and then they had a rope, and they pulled the rope taut, and they put another stake in the ground. And then they walked a little ways, and they pulled that stake, that rope tight again, and put another stake. And then they'd walk a little bit further, and they'd put another stake. And they started putting stakes all the way around their circle. And when they were finished, these stakes were all the same distance from that center point. And then they could say, okay, now we can take a rope and put it around and measure the circumference or the difference around our circle. We also can see that when they put one stake directly across from another, we get the diameter. Diameter, by the way, we always use a lowercase d for diameter and a lowercase r for radius and a capital C for circumference. You see that I've done that in there, but I didn't mention it earlier. So that's pretty cool. But they were saying, well, obviously if we make a longer rope, we get a bigger circle. Or if we make a shorter rope, we get a shorter circle. But what's the relationship? In other words, if our circle is this all the way across here and this is our diameter, how do we know for sure what the circumference is going to be? And so what they did was they took their rope that they had put all the way around their circumference, so I'm going to call this line C, and they laid it out straight. And then they took their diameter and they laid the diameter out straight just on top of that. I'm not going to do a very good job because this is eyeballing it, but there's one diameter. And then they laid it out again, there's two diameters. And they laid it out again, there's three diameters. Let's say it went here. And then there was this little bit left. And what they realized, every time they made a circle and every time they did that, they always had that same little bit left over. Notice this is 1, 2, 3, and this is 0.14, about. And it took centuries for them to figure out what that little bit was. But what it says is that 3.14 diameters equal the circumference. And that makes this formula make sense, because the circumference equals the diameter 3.14 times. That's how many diameters it takes to make a circumference, and that's what pi is. Okay, so first of all, you have to be able to go back and forth between the radius and the diameter. So if the diameter of a circle is 15, what would the radius be? Well, the diameter, we'll make a little one here, if that's 15, the radius is half of that, so that would be 7.5. I should probably have, I did say inches. Okay, good. I was going to say I should have used it, some kind of unit, 7.5. And then here, the radius of a circle is 22 meters. What would be the diameter? Well, the diameter is 2 times the radius, so that would be 44 meters for the diameter. This is R and this is D. All right, so that's going back and forth. And then I just ask you to find the circumference of the figures below. And then I say something weird. Give the exact answer. Do not approximate pi. And then give the approximate answer. Well, one of these has a radius, so I'm going to use the formula C equals 2 pi r for this because I have the radius. So I'm going to say C equals 2 pi, and then instead of radius, I'm going to put in the 4.5. Now, whenever I do this, I want to multiply these numbers. 2 times 4.5 is 9, and so I get the circumference equals 9 pi. This is exact, because I haven't approximated pi. I've just said it exactly. But then I can also approximate, because if I want to do something else with it, then I kind of need a more an answer that I can work with more easily. Even though this is exact, it's not as easy to work with. So if I want to approximate it, then I'm going to say 9 times 3.14. And that's going to give me 28.26. So I could say the circumference is approximately, we use a little wavy lines then, 28.26. And that would be inches because it's just a distance around. Now on the other one, I get 7.5 centimeters, but I'm given the diameter, so I'm going to use diameter times pi. So the circumference is going to be 7.5 pi. Well, I don't have to put the parentheses in there. For the exact answer, I'm done, right? I just have circumference equals 7.5 pi. It's exact still because I haven't approximated pi. But if I want the approximation, then I'm going to actually do the multiplication, 7.5. And you can notice that you have a pi button on your calculator. Most of us do. I could just say times pi. But we don't know, you don't know exactly where that rounded to, because I rounded and said we're going to agree to use 3.14. I could use my pi button, and that gives me 25.561949, which I can round. But what if I had just used my approximation that I said, 3.14? I get 23.55. So you see how using the pi on your calculator can be different than using the approximation? If you're working with a particular online program or your instructor says to use a particular approximation, that's why you don't want to use pi, because you'll get a slightly different but close answer. But remember, it's all approximations once we start rounding pi off, because it's something that goes on forever. I'm going to use the approximation that we said we were going to use and get 23.55, and I'm going to use the wavy lines because it's approximately now, because I've just estimated that. And that's centimeters. All right, have a fantastic day.